Purnya Shlokasya of the great pious king, Kirtaye, we're glorifying Yadu of King Yadu, Priyasya of the deer, Anvavaye in the family of Malayasya, Malaya Hills, Eva as Chandanam, Sandalwood. Translation. Some say that the unborn is born for the glorification of pious kings, and others say that he is born to please King Yadu, one of your dearest devotees. You appear in his family as sandalwood appears in the Malaya Hills.
So, there are two Malayas, one Malaya Hill and one this Malaya, Malaysia, now it is known. Formerly, in this part of the world, Malaysia, they are growing sandalwood in great, large scale. Because 5,000 years ago, there was good demand for sandalwood. Every person should use the sandal pulp because in India it is tropical country, so this is a good cosmetic. Still, those who can afford during very warm days of summer season, if you apply pulp of sandalwood on your body, you feel no warm, it is cool. Yes. So it was the system, still that is going on, but a very small scale, that everyone after taking bath, he should smear over the body with sandalwood pulp. It will keep the body whole day nice, cool and calm. So that was the cosmetic. Now in the Kali Yuga, that is called prasadham. Just like every country, the system is after taking bath, you dress your hair, add something, scented. So in India it was the system that after taking bath, having tilak, going to the deity room, offering obeisances, then the prasadam, chandan prasadam, was taken from the deity room and it was used. This is called prasadhanam. In Kali Yuga, it is said that snana eva hi prasadam. If one can take bath nicely, that is prasadhanam. So much. Come on, this cosmetic or sandalwood oil or rose scent or rose water, these are finished. That snana eva prasadhanam, simply by taking bath. Well, I was in India in the beginning, so taking bath is very ordinary thing, because even the poorest man will take early morning bath. But actually, when I came to our country, I saw that taking bath is also a difficult thing. Taking bath, that is also not in practice. Perhaps once in a week. We are accustomed to see in India thrice in a day. And I have seen in New York the friends are coming to another friend's house because one has no facility for taking shower bath. They're coming to a friend's house, is it not? I've seen it. So, the symptoms of Kali Yuga describe that it will be very difficult also to take even bath. Snana eva hi prasadhanam. And dhyakhyam kutumba bharanam. Dhyakhyam, dhyakhyam means one who is famous for his pious activities. He is called dhyakhyam. Dhyakhyam, this word comes from dhokha. Dhokha means expert. So dhyakhyam kutumba bharanam. In Kali Yuga, if a person can maintain a family, family means wife and a few children, or one or two children, that is called family. But family does not mean in India like that. Family means a joint family. Joint family, the father, the sons, the nephews, sister, her sons, they join together, that is called family. But in the Kali Yuga, it will be difficult even to maintain family. If one can maintain his family, in New York when I was there, one old lady was coming, so she had a grown-up son, so I asked her, why didn't you get your son married? Yes, he can marry if he can maintain the family. I did not know that maintaining a family is a difficult job here. I did not know that. So these are described in the Bhagavatam. If one can maintain a family, he is very glorious man. He is maintaining family. If a girl has got a husband, she is considered to be very fortunate. So actually these things are there. So it is not our business to criticize, but the symptoms of Kali Yuga is very, very severe and it will go more and more. We have simply passed 5,000 years only of the Kali Yuga. But the duration of Kali Yuga is 432,000 of years. Out of only we have passed 5,000 years. And after passing 5,000 years, we find so many difficulties. And the more we grow in this Kali Yuga, the days will be more and more difficult. The best thing is that you finish your Krishna consciousness business and go back to home, back to God. That will save you. Otherwise, if we come back again, the difficult days are ahead, we have to suffer more and more. So, Krishna is described here as Aja. Ajopi san nabhyatma bhutanam isharopi san. That is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Ajopi. I am unborn. Yes, Krishna is unborn, we are also unborn. But the difference is that we have been entangled with this material body. Therefore, we cannot keep our position as unborn. We have to take birth, transmigrate from one body to another. And there is no guarantee what kind of body you are going to get next, but you have to accept. Just like we are accepting in this life one body after another, the child is giving up his childhood body, accepting the boyhood body. The boy is giving up his boyhood body, accepting youthhood body. Similarly, this body of old age, when giving up, natural conclusion is that I will have to accept another body. again childhood body. Just like there are seasonal changes, after summer there is spring, or after spring there is summer there is fall, after fall there is winter, or after day there is night, after night there is day, as these are cycles, one after another. Similarly, we are changing body one after another. And natural conclusion is that after changing this body, I'll get another body. Utta bhutta paliyate. This is very logical and supported by the shastra and spoken by the greatest authority, by Krishna. And why should we not accept it? If you don't accept it, that is foolishness. If you don't think that there is no life after death, that is foolishness. There is life after death. Because we are accepting one body after another since time immemorial, we cannot think of that there is life eternal. It is difficult for us. Just like a diseased man, he is lying down on the bed and eating there, passing stool there, passing urine there, and he cannot move, and very bitter medicine, so many inconveniences. He is lying down. So he is thinking of committing suicide. This life is very intolerable, let me commit suicide. In desperate condition, sometimes the philosophy of voyeurism, impersonalism is forward, to make the things zero. Because this life is so much troublesome, sometimes even one commits suicide to get out of this, troublesome life, a material existence. So the philosophy of voyeurism, impersonalism is like that. They cannot shudder to think of another life, again eating, again sleeping, again walking. Because he thinks eating, sleeping means on the bed, that's all, and suffering. He cannot think otherwise. So the negative way, to make it zero, that is void philosophy. But actually, that is not the case. The case is that you are in trouble on material condition. You get out of this material condition, then there is real life, eternal life. Because we are part and parcel of Krishna. Krishna is Aja. Aja means who has no birth and death. So we are also Aja. How we can be otherwise? If I am Krishna's part and parcel, the same example you can see. If my father is happy, so I am the son of my father, why I shall be unhappy? This is natural conclusion. Because I will enjoy my father's property as my father is enjoying. Similarly, God is all-powerful, Krishna is all-powerful, all-beautiful, all-knowledge, everything complete. So I may not be complete, but because I am part and parcel, so I have got all the qualities of God in part and parcel. It is not that. So God does not die, He is also. So I also will not die. This is my position. And that is explained in the Bhagavad Gita. Na jayate namriyate vakadachi. When he is describing about the soul, Krishna says that the soul is never born. Na jayate namriyate. And if one is not born, how he can die? There is no question of death. Death is for a thing which has got a birth. If one has no birth, there is no question of death. Na jayati, na mriyati va. So we are part and parcel of Krishna, As Krishna is Aja, we are also Aja. That we do not know. This is ignorance. This is ignorance. They are making scientific researches, but they do not know that every living entity is spirit soul. He has no birth, he has no death, he is eternal, nitya, sasatayam, everlasting, purana, all the oldest. Na hannate, the conclusion, na hannate, hannamane, sarire. So after this annihilation of this body, the soul does not die. He accepts another body. This is our disease. This is called bhavarog. Bhavarog means material disease. So Krishna, being the supreme living entity, nitya, nityana, chetana, chetanana. Krishna is exactly like us, or we are imitation of Krishna. The difference is, Krishna is Bhivu, unlimited, and we are Anu, we are limited. That is the difference. Otherwise, qualitatively, we are as good as Krishna. Therefore, whatever propensities Krishna has, we have got all these propensities. Krishna has the propensity to love the other sex. Therefore, we have got this propensity to love the other sex. The beginning of love is there in Radha and Krishna, eternal love between Radha and Krishna. So we are also seeking eternal love, but because we are conditioned by the material laws, it is interrupted. It is interrupted. So if we become out of this interruption, then we will get similar love affairs as Krishna and Radharani. So our business should be how to go back to home, back to Krishna. Because going to Krishna means Krishna is eternal, we get eternal. Just have to become a secretary or even a servant of President Nixon, he is also a big man. He is also a big man. Because unless one has got some special quality, he cannot become personal servant of President Nixon or his secretary. It is not possible. Not ordinary man can become President Nixon's servant or secretary. Similarly, to go back to home, back to Godhead means you get the same type of body as Krishna has got. You become Aja. Aja Nitya Sasatayam. This is a disease that we are changing our body. So Krishna is Aja. So Kunti says, Kachi Kechi Rahu Ajam Jatam. Ajam, the eternal, the unborn, is now has taken his birth. Then, of course we can say that Krishna is taking birth. Yes, Krishna takes birth, but his birth is not like ours. That we should know. It is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Janma karma me dibbam. Jo janati tattat. Krishna is taking birth as the son of Devaki or Mother Yashoda. But he is not taking birth exactly like us. That is described in the Srimad Bhagavatam. When Krishna appeared, he did not come out, from the womb of Devaki. He first of all appeared. You have seen the picture. And then he became a small child on the lap. Therefore, Krishna's birth is transcendental. Our birth is by force, by the laws of nature. He is not under the laws of nature. Laws of nature works under him. Maya dhakshena prakriti suyate sa characharam. Prakriti, nature is working under the order of Krishna. And we are working under the order of nature. That is the difference. See, Krishna is the master of nature. And we are servant of nature. That is the difference. Maya dhakshina prakriti swati. Therefore, Kunti Devi says, kechit ahu. Somebody says like that. That the unborn has taken birth. How the unborn can take birth? It appears like that. But it is not taking birth. It appears just like he has taken birth like us. No. Therefore it is said distinctly, kechit ahu. Some foolish person say like that. And Krishna also said in the Bhagavad Gita, avajananti mana mudha. Those who are rascals, they think that I am also just like ordinary human being. Avajananti mana mudha manasim dehumasita. Because I have appeared just like a human being, so some of the rascals, they think that I am also one of the human beings. No. Param bhava vajananta. He does not know what is the mystery behind the gods taking birth like human being. Param bhava vajananta. So similarly, Krishna is Aja. He takes birth likely, not that exactly he takes birth. He is everywhere. Just like Krishna, it is stated, Ishvara sarva-bhutanam riddhese arjuna tishtati. The Lord is situated in everyone's heart. If that is a fact, see, Krishna is within your heart, within yourself. See, if he immediately comes in your front, so what is the difficulty for Krishna? He is already within. And he's all powerful, just like Guru Maharaj. Guru Maharaj, when he was engaged in meditation, the form meditation, 400 Vishnu he was meditating upon, all of a sudden his meditation broke and he saw the same figure before him, immediately. Is it very difficult for Krishna? He is already within you, and if he comes out, similarly, if Krishna is within the heart of everyone, Devaki also, so if he comes out before Devaki in the same four-handed form, is it very difficult for Krishna? So people do not know. Therefore Krishna says that you have to understand janma karma mit dibbam, transcendental birth. My activities, my birth. Kunti Devi knows that Krishna is unborn. Krishna does not take birth. But it appears like that to some fools. Therefore they say that Krishna has taken birth. But why Krishna takes birth? The next question will be. That is replied, Punna Sloka Sakirtai. Punna slokas. Those who are very pious, very advanced in spiritual understanding, to glorify them. Krishna comes to become the son of Devaki, to glorify Devaki. Krishna becomes the son of Yashoda, to glorify his devotee, Yashoda. Similarly, Krishna appeared in the dynasty of Maharaj Yadu just to glorify. He was a great devotee of Krishna and he is born in the family of Maharaj Yadu. The whole family is celebrated still. Jadava. Krishna's name is Jadava because he took his birth in the Yadu family. So how is it that? that Krishna took. Now the grandfather, the family, exactly the example is given, just like Malaya Seva, Malaya Seva Chandanam. Chandan, this is a tree. A tree can grow anywhere. But the sandalwood tree, because it is very prominent in the Malaysia country, formerly they were growing this chandan tree, as I told you, because there was good demand in India especially of sandalwood. Nowadays they are growing rubber tree, because there is good demand for rubber. So even after business, so the Kunti is giving this very nice example. This chandan tree, it is a particular type of tree. It can grow anywhere, not necessarily that it has to grow in Malaysia or Malaya Hill. There is no such rules and regulation. It can grow anywhere. But because this sandalwood is grown in large quantity in such part of the world, the sandalwood is known as Malaya Chandan. Malaya Chandan. Just like in your western countries, the scented water, Eau de Cologne. Cologne is a country in France, and there it is manufactured. There it is called Eau de Cologne. So similarly, Eau de Cologne can be manufactured anywhere. But originally, because it was manufactured in that Cologne city, it is known as Eau de Cologne. Similarly, sandalwood also can grow anywhere, but because originally it was very prominent in the Malayas, now 5,000 years ago, Kunti is offering this prayer. That means before 5,000 years, the sandalwood was growing in the Malaysia. So this Malaysia is not a new name. It was known thousands and thousands of years ago. All these places, they were Vedic culture. So similarly, he is giving the example that Krishna has no obligation that he has to take his birth in a particular family or particular country. He has no such obligation. But to glorify a certain family or certain person because he is devotee, therefore he has taken birth. The reason is, he is appearing, therefore it is called Dibbham, transcendental. He is not obliged, but we are obliged. That is the distinction between our taking birth and Krishna. We are obliged. If by our karma, by our activities, we are fit for taking birth in a good family, then I will get my birth in good family, or in the human society, or demigod society. But if my activities are lower grade like animals, then I will have to take birth in the animal family. That is force. Karmana daiva netrena jantar deho upapattaye. We develop a certain type of body according to our karma. In this life, this human form of life, is meant for athāta brahma jigyāsa, for understanding the Supreme, the Absolute Truth. But if we do not do so, if we simply remain like animal, then again we are going to the animal form of life. Misuse of the opportunity, then we are. Therefore, this Krishna consciousness movement is trying to save people from going down to animal life. Thank you very much.